Hey guys, so I wanted to do a review on the Unique Mineral Touch Liquid Foundation, and I also got the Unique Touch Glorious Face Primer, and as well I have the concealer and the setting spray. So the instructions say to apply the primer first, so, and then let it set for 5 minutes. So I'm just gonna put a little bit of primer, and I have like the biggest pores around my nose and like right, I don't know, just right at this T-zone area. So, and also, before you do your makeup, make sure you wash off all of your old stuff and get all the dead skin. Because if you don't, you're gonna have some serious dry patches. Okay. So I'm gonna let that set. I'm going to, I'll be right back, 5 minutes. Okay, so it's been about 5 minutes. So I'm going to, so first you wanna take your foundation and get like all the excess out of your dropper before you start shaking it up. So, and it says to shake it for 30 seconds. I don't know, that sounds a little excessive to me, but... Now, I do not have the foundation brush, so I'm going to use, I don't know, I feel like all these, because I think that one's synthetic, and... I don't really have any synthetic brushes, so. So I find the natural soft brushes, they soak up a lot of product. So, okay, that's good. So I'm gonna do like the 5 dropper test, and I'm gonna do like one at a time. So 1 drop I'm gonna put on my chin, I'm just gonna spread it out, and then 2 drops, or 1 drop here, and then 1 drop here, 1 drop there. I'm just spreading out the dot that I do, and then, okay, so that's the 5th dot. Now, when I tried this the first time, it did not cover like it said it was. So I'm just gonna use this Real Techniques brush. It's a lot softer than the one that you're supposed to use, but whatever. So, I don't know, you can see my skin was really red, and I do have blemishes for sure around my chin. My skin is kind of dry right now, so. Okay, so that's kind of all blended in. And okay, so I have like this massive zit right here. I don't know, like, okay, so. For me, I like a full coverage foundation. I find this is like a medium coverage, and it feels really good on my skin. It feels really lightweight, like it doesn't feel heavy like my normal one I use, which is the, I use the Fit Me. I'll show you the bottle here. This is what I normally use, and that feels super, super heavy, and it, that one's medium to full coverage. I would say this one is about a medium coverage, so that was one one layer with this brush. Now I'm gonna go in with a second one. So one dot, I'm just gonna focus it like mostly on my problem areas. And this kind of smells like, it does have a smell. It smells like certs. Like, you know that, you know what certs are? Okay. Oh, okay, now I'm just doing my dots, but I'm kind of blending it all over my face. I don't really have a lot of problem areas on my forehead, so I don't really need a lot. Okay. Okay, so I did five dots. I just kind of already blended. Oh shoot, I wanted to use my beauty blender to see how this one spreads. Okay, so for the second coat, it looks pretty good. I would say two coats of this is perfect for most people, unless you have seriously problematic skin. Now, you can never, with any foundation ever, you can never cover a pimple that's like inflamed and has a bump. You can kind of, you can cover the redness and discoloration, but you'll never hide the bump underneath. Like, it's just not possible. So yeah, for two coats of this, I think it looks really good. It feels super, super lightweight. Like, it feels like skin. Let's see, it transfers a little bit right now. I think it needs time to set, but so I'm gonna go in with the concealer. Now I wanted to point out, because somebody had mentioned to me that they thought the concealer was drying under your eyes and it brings out more fine lines. Now something like this is really thick and pigmented, so it's going to be it'll look a little bit cakey on fine lines if you have any. So middle-aged to mature skin, this, you're gonna want to mix this with your primer. So I'll show you what to do. So okay, so for under eye concealer, you're gonna want to take your little bit of concealer. Actually, I'm gonna put this right under my brush, so I'm using just a flat brush. Take your little bit of concealer, okay? And you're gonna put about half that amount of primer, okay? So I'm just gonna kind of mix it right like that on both sides. And down my nose. And you can just play with it. If you still find it a little dry, just, you know, add a little bit more. But now, I ordered a shade lighter than my skin so I could highlight with it, but if you want it to cover blemishes and stuff, you're gonna wanna order the same shade as your foundation. Now, I don't have the powder, the setting powder from Unique yet, but you're gonna wanna set it as well. So, oh, I gotta plug my nose. Now, don't forget to set it, because if you do not, you'll get creasing underneath your eye. Okay. So make sure you do that step. Now, okay. I'm going to set it and do my contouring and blush and stuff. So I just finished my makeup and I sprayed myself with the setting spray, and ooh girl, that is A1. It just kind of hydrates your skin and makes it look really glowy. I'm kind of digging it. I don't know. What do you guys think? Anyway, so overall, I really I like the foundation, although I do not like how they portray it as a full coverage foundation, because it is not a full coverage foundation. It can be buildable to a full coverage foundation with 10 dropper dots, not 5. And the concealer is definitely good for somebody my age that doesn't have a lot of fine lines. If you're somebody that has fine lines, I would definitely suggest mixing it with the primer. I still found it a little bit dry, and like when I mixed the same amount of concealer, so I'd mix a little bit more than the amount of concealer, if you know what I mean, just to get it that smooth consistency, because you don't want it too thick. Mind you, if you're correcting like discoloration or pimples or anything like that, you can use the thick, just use it without the primer, and just blend it out with a beauty blender. And yeah, I really like the setting spray. Overall, I really, really like it. So yeah, and I'll be getting the powder and bronzer and stuff soon, and I'll demo that as well. Thanks for watching.